Today we have with us Mr. Marty Palmquist, who is the designer and builder of the boat that you're now viewing. The boat has a very unique wing, which adds to its stability and to the sailing speed of the craft. We'd like to ask Mr. Palmquist a few questions about this craft as we go through this tape. Is this craft rigged very much the same way as a regular catamaran or that type of craft?
Yes, it utilizes the sailing rig of a 16-foot catamaran, 16-foot G-cat, and the hull happens to be a G-cat 18-foot hull.
Is the sail rig any larger on this craft than you'd have on a regular catamaran?
No, it uses roughly the same sailing rig.
Do you feel then that you probably have less drag then, because you actually have only one pontoon here instead of the two? Is that the advantage of this design, or one of the advantages of this design?
Well, actually, the design really does not have any advantage over a catamaran at low speeds. This particular boat has a hump speed of roughly 10 knots, and above that, this boat does have an advantage because the drag is actually reduced as the speed increases.
I've always thought that as the speed increases in a catamaran, then the drag increases also. Is that not the case with this craft?
It is up to a point, but like I mentioned earlier, when you reach hump speed of about 10 knots, the drag begins to flow at a rate less than squirrel velocity. And that gives you an advantage over any trimarans or catamaran or any other.
So the bottom line then is that after hump speed is reached, then you can most probably attain much higher speeds in this type of craft than in the catamaran or trimaran type boats.
That's correct. The boat is free to accelerate once it's reached its hump speed, more or less, and you see a noticeable acceleration as the wind speed increases if you are already on the hydroplane. Mm-hmm.
Let's watch this craft in motion for a bit and get an idea of how this wing actually touches the water and, as we'll see later, actually makes a foam that the boat rides on. It appears that this would increase considerably the speed of the boat after that 10 knot mark. How fast is the wind in this particular situation? It doesn't look like there's a lot of wind.
There's only about 3 to 5 knots. It's very light winds right now.
Mm-hmm. The boat then is really not on the hump at this point, is it?
No, it's sailing at about the same speed as a normal catamaran would. Perhaps a little bit faster because right now I have the boat fairly well balanced and the wing is not creating much drag at this point. The reason I'm balancing it is that I'm still below hydroplaning speed, and the wing would not be efficient if it had a heavier load on it right now.
Effect of the wing as it touches the water. You can see that there's really not a wave for the boat to cause a lot of drag, but rather have the airfoil working for it. And it'll be interesting to see the real effects of this as we get into faster winds. Here, evidently, you've got a different wind condition. you're obviously on the hump at this point, and you mentioned that the acceleration is really pronounced once you get up above this point. Is that right?
We are behind a landmass right now, but there's some crests, and you'll probably notice here in a little moment and marked acceleration in a speed right there. We picked up some wind, and it is free to accelerate, and it gets to a point where the boat will go as far as fast as you let it, provided there's sufficient wind.
How much wind do you feel that you're experiencing in this condition?
Okay, we're in the cove right now, and the winds are not steady. And we're getting about 15 knots of wind right here, and sometimes gusting to 20.
I see that our friend has arrived who's going to help us do some photography. We're going to take this opportunity to shoot from a very stable platform on a larger boat, and try to give the viewer a very definite feel of how this new idea and concept actually works. Picking up quite a lot of acceleration here.
Yeah, I'm on a broad tack there. And we just picked up a little bit of a gust.
Mm-hmm. Here we're in the larger boat, and we're shooting from a little bit better vantage point. Explain to us a little bit more of the way the wing approaches the water, and the way the wing can actually cut through the water and not cause any sort of drag as you might think it might. Mm-hmm.
As you notice, a wing has a supercavitating foil on it, meaning that it's not a standard airfoil. It's flat bottom and a wedge shape, and it has a positive angle of incidence built in, and the wing does step over most of the waves, and if there are any sharp waves, it can slice right through them without increasing the drag significantly. Also, the wing flexes so that it can step over the waves quite easily. You can see it flexing in there right now. And you may have noticed that the wing is also swept forward. This places the center lift of the hydroplaning wing forward of the center of gravity, and it helps prevent pitch pulling. In other words, the harder the wind blows, more weight will be transferred over to the tip of the wing, which in turn provides hydroplaning lift forward of the center of effort, and therefore helps steady the boat in the water as it's being thrusted by the wind.
We're already picking up a lot of wind here, it appears. How fast do you think the boat is going at this point?
My speed indicator there was indicating bouncing around 22 miles an hour, but it hasn't been calibrated, so
at this point here, it looks like you're even faster than you were.
That's
you must
right.
be above that that point to some degree, because you're very trim and the boat is running well at this point.
Well, as the speed increases or the wind velocity increases, the hull rises higher up, and my speed probe rises out of the water. It wasn't installed quite right, and therefore I was unable to get the top speed. As a matter of fact, the speed went to zero right on the indicator.
I think that the operator of the photography boat said that you were reaching speeds of about 24 miles an hour on his speedometer at this point. He was was right abeam you at this time, and that looks to be probably about right.
I would have to agree with that.
This picture shows the full effect of the hydroplaning wing, and you can see the almost airplane effect that this boat has. It handles well, it's extremely stable, and takes to weather extremely well.
Yeah, we have about 2 foot waves right there, and it's taking it fairly effortlessly. And you see that the wing will rise over most of the waves, slicing only a few of them.
The boat doesn't appear to bounce at all. It just planes right through all of these waves. It's really interesting to watch the stability that is presented here.
From the spray ahead of the wing, and it the wing rides on a cushion of foam over the surface of the water. The foam helps to break the surface tension and reduce its drag down to almost nothing on the wing. It's a drastic reduction in drag.
What is the steering like in this faster run? Is it still easy to control the boat and steer the boat?
This particular boat has a problem with the rudder yet that hasn't been corrected on this test model, but it is a very stable boat otherwise. There are a few modifications that need to be made yet, but generally it sails real easy. It's very easy to control.
Here's a close-up view of the effect of the wing and just the roughest waves. Even though the photographer was also having a pretty hard ride, you can see that the wing was taken to weather very, very well. Amazing. It's hard to think that the boat could go this fast. What would happen if you made this boat in larger size? Would it do as most sailboats do? Would you really expect a lot more speed than this if you had a larger size boat?
That's correct. I feel strongly that this using this concept and with a few modifications and building a larger boat in the 50 to 60 foot range would enable you to sail at 50 knots or maybe even faster. The basic concept does not have a speed limit, whereas most boats have a speed limit, this one does not. And the stability of the boat increases with speed. therefore, you just have to design the boat that you're building for certain limitations, and that'll determine how fast you will sail, other than the velocity of the wind.
If you had a larger boat, would you have a different steering and control system? You'd have a cockpit, of course, in a larger boat, so that would enable you to have controls more centralized. It would appear that you could have controls that would enable you to control the boat as you would a very large craft, even a motor craft, for that matter.
This boat can easily be controlled by one man, even in a larger size, provided it utilized some of the newer innovations in sail handling. And also the control system that I have incorporated in the pending patent allows you to have positive control of both the pitch and the direction in which the boat sails. That enables you to control the angle of attack for the boat if it momentarily begins, becomes airborne, which it's very feasible that that can happen at the higher velocities and in rough sea conditions.
Mm-hmm. We certainly appreciate you talking with us today. It looks like you have a fantastic design, and it appears that you're well on your way to having a real success. Thank you very much.
Thank you.